Students, myself Sagar Choksi from LJ Institutes of Engineering and Technology. So in previous session we have started a new concept, that is SSS method, and that we have already completed in last session, and we have already completed second topic, that is car subframe. So in today's session we are going to discuss about bus body and vehicle, or you can take commercial vehicle body, right? So in today's session we are going to discuss about three topics. First topic that related to car platform, second topic that related to classification of bus bodies, and third one that is types of construction. So let's start the lecture number 15, that related to bus body and commercial vehicle body. So here the first and important question, that is car platform. So here I have attached one image that related to car platform. So as you can see that in car platform, you can find out there are chassis, there are frame, there are four-wheeler, steering system, and you can find out the seating arrangement, right? You cannot find out here car body. So include integration of this parameter, chassis, frame, four-wheeler, steering system, and seating arrangement, you can find out car platform, right? So first one, that is the definition of car platform. So here I have attached the basic definition. Definition of a platform in car, from a technical point of view, you can include four wheeler, chassis, frame, steering system, and seating arrangement, right? Second one, that is the floor plan, which serve as a foundation for the chassis and other structure and mechanical component. Here you cannot find out the car body, main car body. You can find out the external or you can take four wheeler, steering system, chassis, frame, and seating arrangement. So third one, that is objective. So the front and rear axle and the distance between them, or you can take wheelbase, right? So front and rear axle, here you can find out the, according to segment, you can find out the car platform. Fourth one, that is steering mechanism. Here you can find out steering mechanism and type of power steering, right? So this is what car platform. Fifth one, that is types of front and rear suspension and placement and choice of engine and other powertrain component. So in particular image you can find out types of front and rear suspension, as you can see in image, and placement and choice of engine, right, and other powertrain component, right? So this is what a car platform. It is the integration of all that parameter, right? So move forward to next slide. So next one, that is car platform image. So here I have attached the main image of car platform. As you can find out the chassis, frame, seating arrangement, dashboard, and different types of steering column, right? So this is what car platform, right? So move forward to next slide. So next topic, that is classification of bus body. So here I have attached one image that related to classification of bus body. So passenger carrying buses are classified on based on three parameters. First, that is distance traveled by the vehicle. Second one, that is capacity of the vehicle. And third one, that is shape and style of the vehicle, right? So according to capacity, according to distance traveled, and according to shape and style of the vehicle, you can classify the different types of bus body. So move forward to next slide. So first one, that is based on distance traveled. So here I have attached the main table that related to classification of distance travel, or according to distance travel. Here first and important one, that is town bus. Second one, that is suburban bus. Third one, that is intercity coaches. Fourth one, that is touring coach, right? So this is what based on distance travel. There are four different types of coaches, or you can find out the bus body. First one, that is town bus. Second one, that is suburban. Third one, that is intercity. And fourth one, that is touring bus. Right, so move forward to next slide. So second, that related to capacity of the vehicle. So here I have attached, there are eight different capacity of the particular bus bodies, right? First one, that is minibus, and according to minibus, there are passenger capacity here 8 to 15. Second one, that is small coaches for a long distance, and the passenger capacity, that is 16 to 30. Third one, that is small buses for a town. So passenger capacity for that particular third part, that is up to 40. fourth one, that is medium coach for a long distance, and the passenger capacity, that is 31 to 45. Fifth one, that is medium buses for town, and the passenger capacity, that is 41 to 60. Right. The sixth one, that is large coaches for long distance, passenger capacity, that is 46 to 60. Seventh one, that is large buses for town, passenger capacity, that is 61 to 80. And last one, that is very large bus for town, passenger capacity, that is greater than 80. So this is what capacity of the vehicle. Next, an important one, that is shape and style of the vehicle. So here I have attached the main table that related to shape and style of the vehicle. So the first one, that is normal control ride. Second one, that is single decker. Third one, that is double decker. Fourth one, that is two level. Fifth one, that is split level. Sixth one and seventh one, that is two level. And you can find out articulated buses. This is what the main classification of shape and style of the vehicle. Right, normal control type, single decker, double decker, two level, split level, and articulated buses. So move forward to next slide. So next, an important one, that is minibus. So here I have attached the main concept of minibus. Right here I have attached the two different image. First image, that related to block diagram of minibus, and second one, that is the application. So the first and important one, that is the capacity of minibus. So it should have sitting capacity up to 26. Second one, that is normally built on light duty chassis, because ultimately that is the minibus, and you can find out the light duty chassis. That is, it should have front mounted engine, rear axle drive, soft and comfortable suspension. So this is what minibus. Fourth one, that is reasonably comfortable sitting and fairly small entry platform. So this is what minibus and its application. So move forward to next slide. So here, second one, that is town bus or city bus. So here I have attached the main concept of town bus or city bus. There are two different images, in which first image, that related to block diagram of town bus, and second one, that is the application. So first of all, passenger capacity. So in such buses are used for short distance journey or of up to 30 km. Right. Second one, that is it usually covered with durable trim material such as PVC. Third one, that is due to short interval between stop and local traffic, such buses are provided with wide entrance and exit door. As you can find out the city bus, AMTS bus, right? So this is what town bus. Fourth one, that is town bus are also known as city bus, right? So this is what the town bus or city bus. Such buses are used for short distance journey up or up to 30 km, right? Material that related to PVC. And as you can find out in application, so the AMTS buses are normally the city bus, right? So this is what town bus or city bus. So move forward to next slide. Third one, that is suburban buses. So here I have attached two different images that are related to suburban buses. So first, an important concept, that is the definition. So these buses are used for a distance of about 40 km. And it should have reasonably comfortable sitting arrangement for about 38 person with roof rack for hand luggages, right? So ultimately these buses are used for a distance of about 40 km and the passenger capacity is about 38 person, right? So second one, that is fairly small entry platform for the extra space can be used for luggage and extra standing passenger. So this is what suburban buses, right? Fairly small entry platform, right, for the extra space can be used for luggage. And next one, that is usually one door is sufficient for this type of operation, right? So this is what the suburban buses. So move forward to next slide. Long distance coach. So here I have attached a long distance coach, right? So the kilometer is high compared to minibus or town bus. So first of all, touring coach. So first and important, that is these buses are used for a distance of about 200 km and above. And second one, that is for long distance touring coaches, very comfortable reclining seats are used, right? Second one, an important one, that is the objective. So facility like air condition and TV are provided. And second one, that is additional window in the roof are used to improve visibility for the passenger. So this is what the touring coach. In long distance coach, first and important, that is the touring coach. right? Touring coach that led it to 200 kilometers, right? So move forward to next slide. So second one, that is classic type, right? So here I have attached one image that related to classic type. So classic or normal control bus, as the engine is front of the passenger carrying compartment. Second one, that is the design which was almost universal at one time. As you can see in image, this design, right? This design which was almost universal at one time has practically disappeared. Third one, that is the objective. So low ratio of useful length to overall length. And fourth one, that is it has also high weight and poor aerodynamic shape. So aerodynamic resistance is also a very important concept, as we can find out air resistance is very important. As air resistance is increased, the vehicle performance is decreased. So it also have high weight and poor aerodynamic shape, right? So this is what classic type bus is. So move forward to next slide. Single decker bus. So here I have attached one image that related to single decker bus. So the first one, that is in this type of bus, engine is mounted either inside or below the driver's cab. Second one, an important one, that is such buses may have one or two door, as you can find in image. Third one, an important one, that is the passenger capacity. So many single decker model have seating capacity of 52, which in city bus is reduced to have more space for standing, right? So this is what single decker buses. Passenger capacity, that is equal to 52, which in city buses is reduced to have more space for standing. Fourth one, that is this enable transportation of more passenger for short duration, right? So this is what a single decker bus. So now we can talk about the double decker bus. So move forward to next slide. Second one, that is double decker bus. So in image you can find out the double decker, right? So first and important one, that is this bus is having, or you can find out this bus have rear mounted engine with which afford a front entry or good forward visibility for the passenger. Second one, that is such buses have passenger capacity of approximately 65 to 75. Passenger capacity, that is equal to 65 to 75. Third one, that is it may have upper deck open for tourists, as you can find out in image. Last one, that is double decker buses have poor stability than single decker bus. So ultimately the height is increased, so ultimately double decker buses have poor stability than single decker bus. So this is what double decker bus. So move forward to next slide. So two level single decker bus. So in image you can find out the two level single decker bus. So the first and important one, that is this type of buses are used as luxury coaches. And second one, that is the layout, here you can find out the layout provide good forward visibility for all passenger and good separate luggage space under the floor. So this is what two level single decker bus. As you can find out in image, I have attached two different image. First and important one, that is two level single decker bus. This type of buses are used as a luxury coaches. And second one, that is the layout. Layout provide good forward visibility for all passenger. So this is what two level single decker bus. So last one, that is articulated buses. So here I have attached two image that related to articulated buses. So I have attached the two parameter, first parameter and second parameter. So the first and important one, that is these are very large coaches for in city operation. And second one, that is these are made of two parts. In image you can find out there are two different parts, right, in left side and in right side. So these are made of two parts because of axle load limitation. And second one, that is the rear is articulated to the main vehicle. So this is what articulated bus is. So thank you so much. In this particular session we have completed main classification of different types of bus body. So in next session we will discuss about the construction of bus body. So thank you so much.